Short people got nobody. Short people got nobody to love. They got no baby leg. They stand so low. You got to pick them up just to say hello. They got little cars that go beep, beep, beep. They got
since my father died.
You know, I have a child with transgender. You know, I have a child with transgender. Well, whether she is or not, and, you know, my point is that she is not transgender.
An alternate reality. 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 Come on.
You know, I have a child with transgender. Is that she is not transgender.
Welcome, everybody, to the show tonight. I'm here to fry somebody that won't keep their mouth shut, even though I was told to ignore them. Ignoring them doesn't work. When are you going to learn? Are you ever going to learn? You can't lie about people on your podcast. Naughty, naughty. You can't do that. And you can't go around telling people crazy shit like you do. Let's listen.
Police, location, sheriff department, what have you. And they say unbelievable things to make them believe that you, at your certain address, that there's something evil going on. Everybody's laughing at this bitch with her empty threats. The fact that people lose their IQ points, though, that is disturbing. Stay away from that woods of hatred. I mean, I think that's the best definition, the woods of hatred. You know, and there's better things to listen to. And unless you're just that core group of 20 or so people that listen.
Stop. Her last show that she broadcast had 22 listens. Mine had 94. The one before that was 160. Unless you're just that 20 core people that listen. Oh, we're going to make this bitch wish she had never opened her fucking mouth before we're done.
I know. I just let her live in her own little world. And it is little. Very little. We're all out here doing what we want to do because we enjoy it. If you don't enjoy it, why the hell are you here? Because aren't we just humans having sexual experiences?
Stop. Now, ever since you've been podcasting, I've never heard you go on a date. I've never heard you entertain a gentleman. I don't believe you've had sex in 8 years, to be honest with you, at least not with a human. Huh?
Gosh. Yeah, I saw that she made a comment about me looking for a house, which I'm really hating right now. And I thought it was somebody's another show. I'll be damned if I push that play button. I did one time within the last, since January, and I felt so bad about it. I accidentally pushed the play button. I'm like, shit. It was because she had some different host on her avatar. And I thought it was somebody's another show. I mean, my God.
Oh, my God. She never misses my show. She's listening right now. She is obsessed. Well, Debbie, you act like you're obsessed with her, you might say. No, I'm obsessed with defending myself against this psychotic bitch. You don't understand the history here. You don't know what I've been through with this psycho. This psycho has had me in her crosshairs since 2011. I swear to God. I know you all believe me because you know I don't have the balls to lie. I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to give one of you the pleasure of calling me out and making me look like an idiot. Fuck you. I'm telling the truth. This woman is psychotic. And she has had me in her crosshairs. It's what she does to people. And I'm in the mood to send her running.
You know, at least I can talk about different topics.
Yeah, you can talk about different topics. All you talk about is me. In fact, we have a running bet here on the show of how long it takes you to mention me the minute you hit the play button. Everything I do is a response to your psychotic bullshit. I think people finally figured out that this woman is a freaking psycho. I think they've hung out with me long enough to realize I don't do the things that she says I do. And she just talks like this with her vocal fry and all her bullshit. And everybody sees what she looks like. You don't look good, bathtub girl. You don't. They've seen my videos. They know I'm not full of shit. I have blonde hair, blue eyes. I don't have wrinkles on my skin. I don't look like a fat, stupid, ugly pig like you do. So stop with the sexy voice. You're not fooling anybody, okay? You don't look like your voice.
And I can actually bring a real speaker. I guess I can't say who that is. But it'll be good. I ought to tell you. Well, I can't tell you offline because you...
Oh, just like you can always never tell what you're doing with me because it's always a secret. Well, never mind. I would tell y'all what I'm doing. I'm having a conference call with Blog Talk Radio on Saturday, and I'm so excited because life is so good right now. Life is so good. I'm buying a $300,000 house, and I don't know how to do that. Can somebody tell me how to buy a house? I just don't know because I like acting like a little stupid girl, even though I'm a 300-pound oof who likes to pick on other women. This is all reactionary. I don't like that word. This is reactionary to your bullshit. This is me, tired of being quiet. And frankly, she let it slip one time in about the year 2014, I believe, or 2013. She said on her show one night, she said, somebody says, why do you call Debbie the dumpster? She says, because you can dump on her and dump on her and dump on her, and she never dumps back. Not anymore.
I have a tendency to talk to her, so that's no big deal. But do the best I can. That's all. And yeah, they can tell. I think they're wise enough to understand that she is a problem. And I'll trust that they'll make the best choice possible.
But I thought you never made complaints to Spreaker.com. You made over 350 to Blog Talk Radio, 358 to be exact. 358 complaints. You're forgetting I had friends in the administration office. Now you'll tell everybody that I was paying them extra because you're batshit crazy.
When it comes to her. Why does she listen to me all the time? That, you know, I really do not understand that. And when I was on Goose's show, you know, Goose had pulled her on, and I was wanting to know, why does she want me back on her show? Anytime she does contact me, she is always wanting me to come back.
Bitch, I never contact you, I never have contacted you, and I never will contact you. Let's listen to this lie. This is a big one here. Check this out. This one's almost laughable.
She is always wanting me to come back to her show, and I will not. I mean, no, I'm not going to drink the dumpster juice or get inside the dumpster. I mean, it's just nasty, gross, and you're never going to get decontaminated.
Now, in a moment, Sweet Pea is going to tell you that she never stoops to the levels that the dumpster stoops to. She's just not that way, she says, although she compares me to an animal and continues to call me the dumpster. Let's listen.
I mean, I regret being her co-host. Oh, I regret that.
Bitch, you were never my co-host. You were a bothersome caller, which I will be happy to back up and prove. I never say anything I can't back up 100%. You got on my nerves. You got on everybody's nerves. Ralph O'Rama hated you. Everybody hated you on the show. You splashed around in some bathtub and overtalked me all the time. Everybody was saying, get rid of her, Debbie. I regret being her co-host. Oh, I do. You were never my fucking co-host. Shut up.
I wish I had a do-over button.
I'm sure you do. And you would probably make the decision to not be a whore when you were younger. And you would probably make the decision to actually go to college and get yourself educated, okay? And you would probably make a lot of decisions different. How about that, Angela? Report that to Spreaker, bitch.
And she would never have been in my life.
The night I took your first call, I've told people before in my real life and in my personal life and in my online life that I believe that was the moment that darkness walked into my life. I believe that was when Satan entered my life, was the night I took your first freaking phone call. Oh, I just wish I had a do-over button. Choke on it, you... Ugh.
I really don't have a lot of stupid people in my life, if you understand what I'm saying. Oh, my God. Why would she do that to you, though? I mean, I don't understand. If she hates me so much, why does she want to listen to my voice?
Because intelligent people know you keep your friends close and your enemies closer. I have to listen to all the bullshit that you're spewing over there. It's fantastic to listen to. It's like listening to a three-year-old that's mad at his best friend. Tell these outlandish stories. You're hysterical, and I love it.
But I just wanted to say that I've never known Wild Goose to swat anybody. He's a person in the world, but that's giving her some intelligence, and I don't want to do that. You know, even when she did get swatted, I would never have supported anything like that.
Okay, first of all, I've never been swatted. In the year 2009, was it 2009 or 2010? 2010, there was a well check sent over by some people, which was turned out to make me more popular than I ever was. And then... pushing forward to 2015, I guess, when somebody I know, which it probably could have been you, oh, how I wish you would do it again. Please, God, if there is a God, let her do it again. I beg you, because she's too stupid to know how to block her number, but she certainly knows how to swat. I can tell you that for damn sure.
Jaw-dropping that people would go there.
Oh my God, it's just jaw-dropping that people would go there. If you knew some of the shenanigans that this insane person has done in her real life, she has had people set up by the cops. I mean, she's absolutely evil. Evil. She's had people leave Tulsa to get away from this psycho.
You know, it's... I know, I'm sure he's a smart young man. I'm sure he is. Been able to get things done. I helped indict a sheriff. Getting a sheriff out that's been there for 27 years. That is not true. That is so not true.
It's a little jumpy because I had my audacity going when I was listening to her psycho babble. But we can listen to it in its entirety. Some of her psycho babble. Now the latest psycho babble... where Angry Bong owned her on her own show about me was saying things about me she got pissed off about and hung up on Joe because she said that he was white knighting me. Joe was not white knighting me, trust me. Joe was simply putting her in her place, and she didn't like that, so she hung up on him. And then she kicked Stabby McHugs out of her chat room. But she didn't know how to do the ban button. I don't know how to do this. Bitch, you ban every sock account I come in there with in 10 seconds. I don't know how to ban. Tee-hee-hee-hee-hee. I'm such a innocent little sweetie pie girl. I don't know what to do. How do you ban somebody? I don't know. I'm so fucking sick and listening to you. I'm going to make you wish you had never started your stupid web of lies as your last intro used to be. Here's the real show. I've never known Goose to be a swatter.
Location, sheriff department, what have you. And they say unbelievable things to make them believe that you, at your certain address, that there's something evil going on. And it requires the services of the SWAT team. And they use a variety of proxies. They do different things in order to make it look so the SWAT team comes in, and they're pretty brutal. They'll blow out doors, windows, and they see something move and it doesn't stop. There goes Fluffy, your cat. I'm sorry, I don't mean to laugh. But come to my attention that someone is accusing Wild Goose of swatting. And I have to say that that is just not the case.
When did I accuse Goose of swatting? It has come to my attention that someone is accusing Wild Goose of swatting. Bitch, this hasn't come to your attention. You're my number one listener on my statistics. Oh, we're just getting warmed up.
I've heard a lot of things. I haven't seen a lot of things, but I've heard a lot of things in Skype conversations, and it comes to my logic that if something had happened, like, let's say Goose did do something repulsive or, you know, something along that lines, and I think I would have heard some rumbles. Biological father busted his cell phone on, how do we say it? Child of her child. And it is what it is. There's other people that have laid claim to being swatted. Repulsive or, you know, something along that lines. And I think I would have heard some rumblings. I think I would have.
Yes, because the BWC lets Angela Truth know every move they make, right?
No, and it is what it is. There's other people that have laid claim to being swatted. You know, I heard there's this crazy grandma in Texas that's threatened her, how do we say it? Child of her child's biological father, who I believe had custody of the child. I don't know.
Nope, wrong. Never had custody. Another lie. Who I believe, I don't know, had custody of the child. But I never get into her personal life. Never. She gets into my personal life. Listen to this psycho.
So it's all so confusing to me. And I just don't give a shit. But now that's a person that has admitted to threatening her child of a child's biological father.
Child of a child's biological father. Y'all want to talk about threatening somebody? You want me to get serious with this shit? You want me to really get serious with this shit and point out how psycho this bitch is? Talking about threatening people? Are you kidding me? You don't even want me to go there. I'm going to keep my cool and not even go there.
Busted his cell phone on the driveway. Became violent. No wonder she's not supposed to be around the grandchild.
No wonder she's not supposed to be around the grandchild. Really? I'm around the grandchild, I don't know. Every day? Hold on just one second. In fact, I'll show you guys a little secret that I have. Where did I do with it? What did I do with my cell phone? Aha! I still have Victor's credit card. Where did I do with my cell phone? Where did I leave it? Left it somewhere. Hold on just a second. Let me take a look and see. Here it is. Got it. No wonder she's not supposed to be around the grandchild. What a wicked person you are. You're horrible. Ugh. It's just gross. Let's take a listen to how I'm not supposed to be around the grandchild. Shall we?
Say something. Lisa, can you come to Katrina with us tomorrow? I love you. Bye-bye. And to Papa, can you come to Katrina with us?
The absolute love of my life, the reason I breathe, the most beautiful angel in the world, an absolute charming buttercup, blue-eyed angel baby doll love. No wonder she's not supposed to be around the grandchild. Ah, it's almost like you can hear this witch cackle.
But I just want to make it clear, to the best of my knowledge, Wild Goose has never swatted anyone. I know. Some of you are thinking, who the hell cares, right? Unless you're the one being swatted. Yeah, see, everybody's laughing. Everybody.
Angela, that's an MP3, okay?
Everybody's laughing at this bitch with her empty threats. The fact that people lose their IQ points, though, that is disturbing. Stay away from that woods of hatred. I mean, I think that's the best definition, the woods of hatred. You know, and there's better things to listen to. And unless you're just that core group of 20 or so people that listen.
I'm not touching that one.
I know, I just let her live in her own little world, and it is little, very little. We're all out here doing what we want to do because we enjoy it. If you don't enjoy it, why the hell are you here? If people are making you so miserable, why do you stay?
I stay because I have a lot of listeners. People aren't making me miserable. I think that's you, Angela. You won't even say my name. You're too scared to. And I love the one like on your last show. I'm sure that was you.
That's my question. Maybe that can be a topic for tonight. You know, just maybe we could blow some fairy dust, you know, the ogle effect, you know, bending over, spreading cheeks and taking it up in, you know. You know, I'm convinced that he's a closet, you know.
A closet what, princess? A closet what? What are you calling him? A closet what? Since you think you're so fucking good on this broadcast that you have. If anybody deserves not to have a podcast on this situation here that we have going, it's this woman. She just lives to just lie about me. I mean, I wouldn't mind. I'm being honest. I dare anybody to come forward and say, prove it. Oh, I can prove stuff. Everything she says is a complete facade. She has created somebody to hate, to expel all of her bullshit on.
By the way, but I was just wondering if your child is autistic, if that's true, what was said.
Okay, she just accused me of saying that the Jew's Jonathan is autistic. If that's true, what was said. It's almost like you can hear this evilness behind her, like this evil witch cackling or something. If that's true, what was said. The only thing I've ever said about Jonathan is he is brilliant beyond belief. He was reading at a third grade level at age 7. He's beautiful, and he's like the top in his class, and he's working on a black belt in Taekwondo.
I'm sure he's a smart young man. I'm sure he is. But I think people should stay clear of people's children. I just did.
Oh, wait. Let's go back and refresh our memories. I think people should stay clear of people's children. Let's go back and refresh.
Yeah, see, everybody's laughing. Everybody's laughing at this bitch with her empty threats. The fact that people lose their IQ points, though, that is disturbing. Stay away from that woods of hatred. I mean, I think that's the best definition, the woods of hatred. You know, and there's better things to listen to. And Unless you're just that core group, you know, bending over, spreading cheeks, and taking it up in, you know. You know, I'm convinced that he's a closet, you know.
Remember what she said earlier about the grandson? She's not even allowed to be around the grandson. Oh, I'm skipping around so much of this because it's just hysterical. You can click anywhere on any of her shows and she's mentioning me. Anywhere.
Pulling everybody down to her level. To step away and be back to who you are. You know, I become ill. I stay away for a little while and then I come back and it's the same old shit.
You're a meth addict. You're a methadone addict, and you spend 24 hours of your day worrying about where you're going to get your next fix. I happen to know secrets about you, Angela, because your ex-best friend came to me. Don't forget about that. You can discredit her all you want, but ex-best friends know the reality of you. And I was told pages upon pages upon pages of your little reality.
Doesn't anybody want to get beyond that and have some real entertainment?
Oh, I think this is very entertainment. Very entertaining. I think people love when I make a fucking fool out of you, you stupid bitch. I'm going to report her to Spreaker, and I think that Spreaker will make the right decision about her. And then she says, I never make reports to Spreaker. That's just not true. That's just not true. Notice how she goes, true, when she's lying. Her voice just goes, true.
You know, or informational programs. I mean, I realize the name of my channel, or whatever you want to call it, Infotainment News, is a play on words, and maybe it's not the nicest play on words, but because it sounds like Ebonics.
Let's don't touch that one.
But it's real. And when I have been well enough, I've been able to get things done. I helped and died a sheriff.
No, you didn't. Investigations were done, and no, you didn't. You sold out your daughter. You even made her lie on the poster she was holding. Sheriff Clance, or whatever his name was, beat my father. He has to go. And by the way, I might add that I just thought you looked lovely in that picture. It'll be on my avatar tonight. I'm going to contact Spreaker. I was in the judge's chambers.
I was a part of that group. You know, and there's people that say, oh, she just went to one. Oh, what was it?
Rally.
Protest. No, no, no. In the heat of the summer, I'm getting signatures for the petition.
From what I learned, they were illegal signatures from people that weren't registered voters.
Or I'm speaking with people, or I'm going to all these different meetings. And
bullshit. Your friend says you never leave your house unless it's nighttime and you only leave out the back door. You never answer the front door because it's probably somebody trying to serve you with a protective order. Huh? How about that?
We're still doing it, by the way. It's crazy. I mean, it's crazy good, mind you. You know, we're going to the drunk checkpoints when they stop people to see if they've been drinking. We're filming that. If we're on public property, we're allowed to.
I believe that's called, what is that called? That's called, what do you call that? When you stop people that are drinking. Well, it's time to tell a little bathtub girl secret. A little secret is, and she actually told me this herself one time on my show. I could find the audio if you want me to take the time. You know I could. She says, well, I had this ex-fiance. Everybody's an ex-fiance. How do you become an ex-fiance? I had this ex-fiance one time that he dared to mess with me and my children, my minor children, which are now 21 and 17, I think. But he dared to come at me. So you know what I did? I found out where he was drinking at a bar, and I called the Tulsa sheriffs. And I arrested him. And I thought, wow, what a fucking bitch to do something like that. You know, that's evil. I've never done anything like that in my fucking life. I mean, I've gone through some drunk checkpoints, but luckily most of the DPD know me and they're like, go on.
And that's our legal right. And I've noticed during those times that we did filming, not one person was charged with resisting arrest.
That's because you were there, Princess, and everybody in the community fears you, right? You're so powerful.
Like, so happens so much in Tulsa, where I live. You know, and I feel pretty proud of that. We have some other things we want to make changes in, but getting a sheriff out that's been there for 27 years
is not something to be proud of. Okay. Not something to be proud of. I wouldn't be bragging about that if I were you, but that's just me. Let's skip ahead.
Here, when it comes to different white privilege, and at least where I live, it's a lot different where I live. It's like going back in time to.
Yes, because you were raised in, what was it you said that time on your show? You had to sit with white gloves on and your hands crossed. Are you fucking kidding me? You were raised in a trailer getting lots of daddy love while your mother looked the other way. Are you kidding me? Bitch, you're damaged goods, and hating me is not going to take all that away. You need what's called therapy. Therapy, okay? Hating me is not going to take away all your pain. It never worked with all those other people, did it? All those other women who put you under protective order. Hating women is not going to make you who you want to be.
20 years. And I only came on here to say that Goose does not SWAT, that, to the best of my knowledge, to the best of my knowledge. You know, has he done things that I did not like yet?
Yes, he actually had you take down your show one time. And that's all I'll say.
Yes. I know, but he's not the only person in my life that have done things that I did not like. Oh, wait. Oh, really? Why is she playing me on her secret show? Why did you come here and put all those? Oh, okay, I get it. I get it. All right. Well, maybe she'll complain. That is not true. That is so not true.
Wait a minute. I bumped into my computer here. Hold on.
You're writing hundreds of complaints.
Here comes a big one.
That is not true. That is so not true.
That is so not true. Really, not according to Anna Piazza. She's so sick of your complaints about me, she doesn't even open them anymore. Blog Talk Radio deleted them before they even saw them. They had something in their computer system that said Debbie Daly from Bathtub Girl, and they just had it to where it wouldn't even come into their system anymore. They were so fucking sick of listening to you. Which, by the way, you got 404'd by them, not by me. You just wouldn't believe how many people she had 404'd on Blog Talk Radio. We just ran away and left her all alone over there. Really? Check the records.
You need to look in the mirror. You need to watch her look in the mirror. You know, I don't know what happened to this woman that...
Bitch, I was raised on Walton Mountain compared to your raisings, okay? It just cracks me up. It fucking cracks me up, this psychotic woman. And she won't go away. No matter what app, if I ignore her for 300 episodes, she won't go away because she's obsessed. I'm on her mind, I think, I'm on her mind right now, 24 fucking hours a day.
Made her so insecure and empty.
Come on our bun hunt.
Mm-hmm. What?
Butt Hunt 2015.
Is this the back page?
Yes, I can set you up with any kind of woman you want, or man. What do you need?
We need a Texas blonde.
Mm. Yeah. Do you like skinny, muscular girls with a let's see, what does Victor say? With an ass you could set a dime on and get 10 cents change, huh?
Is she going to bring me a cheeseburger?
I used to say, it's an ass you can throw an egg at and it'll bounce right back.
Victor says the same thing about mine. He always goes, damn, baby, I love watching you walk away from me.
That's
what's going
what
on?
Get the fuck out.
You got some junk in that trunk.
Yeah. Not much, not much. We just thought we could be feisty, too.
Oh, I'm having so much fun. Were you listening to me?
Yes.
I love it. Oh, don't go to the dumpster. Are y'all going to get dumpster juice all over you?
Don't get the dumpster juice. You know, I've told this chick, you know, these chicks come on here and they want to, like, know me on Skype, but they, like, they never call. Like, when I call them, they automatically hang up.
From Backpage?
I don't know who the fuck these are.
Is that the girl with the gigantic boobs that time that has, that's a squirter, that girl?
No.
Oh, okay. No,
this is,
disappeared.
Yeah, this chick, her name is Cinnamon Lover.
Cinnamon Lover.
I don't. You know, I like cinnamon too.
Cinnamon is actually the most one of the healthiest things that you can consume. Did you know that?
I've heard that before too. Yeah.
You should do the cinnamon test, Mr. Midnight Movie.
I'm gonna test my blood sugar at the end of the show.
Let's ring somebody into the call here. Let's ring Cinnamon Love into the call.
I'm gonna add her to the group. Let's see. She's not gonna pick up though.
Damn it.
See, she just hung right up on me.
She's got you blocked.
Really?
Yeah, if it hangs up automatically, you're blocked.
Oh, dude, that's great.
Fuck. Dude, she texted me. She, like, Skype chatted me.
She's toying with you.
She wants me to, you know what
then
she wants me to
popped
do?
Up.
She wants me to spend, no, but she wants me to spend money to talk to her. Okay. And I will not talk to any bitch for money.
Fuck that noise.
I'm calling her again.
She's got you blocked. You're blocked, baby dove.
Oh, fuck.
Fuck.
No cinnamon love.
No cinnamon love.
Let's make some phony phone calls. Let's call the Bunny Ranch in Las Vegas, shall we?
Yeah. I want to get one who's going to wrestle.
Let's call the Bunny Ranch.
Doesn't Texas have an equivalent?
No, there's one in Atlanta and in Nevada.
It's legal in Nevada?
Now, don't tell him that. He'll go there.
Yeah, really, I thought
you don't know that, I'm not helping you.
We need the phone number to the Bunny Ranch, please. We're looking under Contact Us. Ooh, these got some good-looking girls there. You might like some of these, Mr. Floovy Pops.
Cinnamon Lovar.
Cinnamon Lover. I need some Kleenex for my nose!
Yeah, right. Bunny Ranch, what is your number, sweet bun buns? Can anybody find their number? I don't see it.
Let's call a few strip clubs and see if any who's working tonight.
We can do that. Let's do. It's a Friday night before Halloween. I bet they're really rocking. Let's call here in Dallas. Let's call. What was it called? Royal? Something Royal? Let me see. Strip clubs. You know, Clint Goldberg used to own most of them. Seriously?
Didn't? Mm-hmm. Yeah. And what happened to him?
He got ran out of Dallas on a rail.
Jesus.
He did.
Why?
For freaking out on the air when he couldn't find me.
What an idiot.
Yeah, he gave up one of the best. We can call the Silver City. Where's your number? Oh,
yeah,
here it
I
is.
Just sent it
you
to
have you. A chat message from JP.
What is that?
Bunny Ranch.
Stop. All right. I've got this one, too. Let me just make a note of it. All right. Here we go. Calling the Bunny Ranch. Who's going to talk?
I'll talk.
Yes.
All right. You talk, and I'll be on there to back you up if you need to, okay?
Okay.
I'll say I'm going to send my husband there for Halloween or something like that.
She doesn't want to have sex with me anymore, so I'm...
Well, I don't mind sharing. How about that?
Oh, just say you don't want to hear fridge and bits and you don't want to have sex anymore.
God
Come on.
Damn it. See, I can't do it anymore. You have to add them to the call, JP. I can't. Did you see where it says it?
No. Mr. Midnight Movie, add them.
Add them.
Let me do that.
Do you know how to do that?
I'm doing it right now.
Well, he's good.
Yeah, we've whipped him into shape.
Hello, Bunny Ranch.
I'm a little nervous.
That's an odd ring. What country code are you calling? Country code 93.
This is going to cost you $50,000, by the way.
No, it's...
Yeah. You know what? That number's not right.
Oh, jeez. Hello?
Sorry about that.
Here. I don't like it.
Is this the Bunny Ranch?
Hello?
Hello?
Fine. Are you fine?
Is this the Bunny Ranch?
Yes, this is the overseas operator. This is the overseas operator. What country are we reaching, please?
Listen in English.
Donde está vive?
El Bunny Ranch?
Yes, I can speak English.
No English?
No comprende?
No, yes, I know English. If you speak English, I...
What do you speak?
I speak with English.
Do you speak Dutch? What country code? Dutch? Okay, we can speak Dutch. Hold on just one second.
Deutsch?
Momento. I mean, I don't know. Okay, let's see.
¿Cómo se llama?
Uno momento.
Should you be forgiven?
Hold on just a second, boys. All right, here we go. Is dit hun konnichti ranch? Hello, is this the Bunny Ranch? Does he speak?
If you know English, okay?
Okay.
Hello?
Yes, is this the Bunny Ranch? Where are we reaching?
Holland?
Hello?
What country is this? Hello, what country are you? It's Afghanistan. Oh, hello. Hello, Afghanistan. We were wondering, is this the, how you would say, place for having sex? We're calling?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we're calling from America.
What?
Are you Muslim?
Yeah, pardon, once again, sir, I didn't know what you said.
Are you under fire right now?
Yes.
Oh, I'm very sorry to hear that. Jesus Christ, guys. What the fuck? I'm sorry to hear that. Do you know Bill Wagoner?
Sorry, I didn't understand. Because I'm in city, there's more cars, there's two people. I didn't hear your speaking.
Yes. We are calling from Israel.
Yes. Andy Bong. Hey, Andy Bong. Does that ring a bell? Andy Bong?
We want to help you. Is ISIS attacking
you?
Yes. Is ISIS attacking you right now? This is making me nervous.
Okay, sir. I'm ready. I good. The interview. And here I speak with you English right now. Okay, what's up?
Do you need help?
I need help.
Do you need help? Do you need assistance?
Sir, would you like us to call George W. Bush?
And would you like us to call Andy Bong?
Barack Obama. Do you know who that is?
Bill Wagner.
Wild goose.
Don't say that.
Oh, yes.
Don't say that.
Yes. Hey, a wild goose.
Angela, ask him another question, please.
My name is Angela. I'm calling from America. This is America calling. Are you there? They're probably tracing this fucking call. We're going to get killed.
Sir, are you there? Hello.
My name is Bill. Oh, man.
We called fucking Afghanistan, Jewish producer.
Did
you
really?
Idiot. Yes, the country code 93 is Afghanistan.
Well, you put that in. I didn't. Debbie put that in. The number I have is in the chapel room. Just call that one.
Yeah, you didn't do it. You didn't do it right, Debbie.
Debbie.
Damn me.
I think that was, you were trying to.
So we calling back?
No.
I think you were trying to do a block on your own number, right?
No, I swear to God. I just put in, I'll do it again. I'll put in 77, this number right here. Watch. I'm going to copy it. And then, well, first I'll show you my screen so you'll believe me. You know I never pop singers, you little turd butts.
No, no, I thought you were just, I thought it was like Star 93.
No, I put in add people, then I put in the number, watch. And then I put, but it doesn't.
Mr. Midnight Movie, add that number.
But look, when I hit enter, look what it shows up to be. We need to take out this star, this plus 93, and just put in a 1, but I can't change it. I'm not calling him back. That was weird. Mm-hmm. I said I was ISIS. Isn't that horrible?
Mr. Midnight Movie, are you calling it?
Yeah, let me call it. Hold on.
Yeah, hold just on. Take out the country code.
Wait,
why is he
for
doing
it.
That?
Oh, fuck. Hold on.
What the hell? Come on.
I'm trying.
If you had started this 5 minutes ago, you would have been fine.
Okay. Here we go.
At least the Jew isn't here.
Fuck him. Have him call. No. No, I don't want to talk to that guy. Should we add him? Have you made up with one angry Jewy?
No, and I'm not going to.
Movie, call that number.
Okay. Add people to this call.
Add people to this call.
La, 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 la. 1.
That's the number to the Silver City strip bar here in Dallas. We could call them and see if...
Whoa, what? Don't confuse him. We're trying to get this
who's
one
who's on the main stage right now. Well, while he's doing that, we'll call this one. Why is Star 93? Oh, I've got my country is Afghanistan. Let me change that.
Why are you calling Afghanistan?
No.
Because I've got my country set to Afghanistan on my Skype. Ooh, that's serious, isn't it? Go ahead. I'll wait. General, where do I change that at? I don't even know. I don't know how I did that, but
it's
I did
it. It's not letting me do it.
It's not?
We're probably going to get killed now. I don't want to get killed. How do I change that? I don't forgot how I change it. Crap. Messaging. I forgot. I put my country code as Afghanistan. Just to throw people off.
No.
Oh, Lord. How do I change that?
All right, Debbie. Call. He's not able.
What's he doing?
I'm doing it right. Yeah, I'm doing it right now.
All right.
Hold on.
No, my country code is Dallas. It's United States. Y'all must have yours set to Afghanistan. I don't know what the fuck.
Who did that?
I didn't do anything.
Me either.
Damn it. Oh, fuck. God damn it. How do I clear the fuck? Oh, fuck it. God damn it. How do I... You know what?
What, baby?
This shit's not as easy as it looks, honey bunny.
Hey, don't really? Listen to me. I'm not...
Fuck! Jesus fucking... Okay, dial the number and I'll add it in. I can't...
Huh?
Let me add this shit again. All right, let me add...
Okay, just hit that plus button and add a caller if it'll
I'm
let
adding,
you.
Okay, yeah. When I went to do it, it okay. And
you ruined the show.
I'm pressing add the call, and it's not allowing me to do it. All right, here we go. This is back to Afghanistan. Let's call the Afghan people again. Are we calling the Afghani people?
What do they speak? So I can get a translator real quick.
They speak Arabic.
Arabic, okay. Here we go.
Allah Akbar!
No, don't say that. All right, I'm going to say...
Hello, I'm a Jew.
Well, the chat's turning on me, I hear.
Merban Kaf Halk. What the fuck?
Murahiban. كيف حالك؟
Behind him.
We can do this if they answer. Are they is it dialing? Let's call that other guy back. No? Because I can be typing the words as fast as he asks me questions. And then I can just go.
مرحباً. كيف حالك؟
I'm hearing I'm grind. MM on Adderall. I was just...
هل أنت في حاجة إلى المساعد؟
That's are you in need of assistance?
Huh.
I'm telling you, just get them back on the line and I'll talk to them like that and see what they say.
Okay. They don't speak Arabic, you turd. What's his face just said? They don't speak Arabic.
Gabby.
What? Do they...
هل قطع رأس زوجتك؟
Read in Arabic.
That's okay. Have you beheaded your wife.
هل قطع رأس زوجتك؟
Okay, what do they speak?
What do they speak?
What do they speak, Stabathon?
Stabby, what do they speak? What language do they speak, Stabby?
Stabby McSmart.
Stabby's an ISIS anyway. Come on, Stabby. Tell us what they speak so we can save the world. They don't speak Arabic?
Do then what do they speak? Does anybody know? Dump the dumpster.
Do they speak
Wink.
Farsi? No, they don't. Okay.
Guess who has called me to flirt with me, dumpster? A man in need of love. You make Vic puke. He would rather have sex with a donkey.
They speak Peshato.
JP, and, does your wife know Dari. That you abuse women online?
Well, you're so smart, Sammy.
I thought you were never going to listen, Angela. I never pitch play on her show. That's Angela, by the way, with a picture of my beautiful husband.
My wife laughs when I talk about BTG.
You should hear Victor.
So they speak Peshato and Dari. But I don't think that buttface is going to talk to us anymore.
He'll talk to the recording that I have. Dump the dumpster. JP, does your capital wife, capital no, capital U, capital A, capital... Fuck.
When are you moving to Thousand Oaks?
What if one of your... ex-fiancés that's a rancher is going to buy you a $300,000 home.
Yeah, Who are you going to mooch off of?
He called me, not the other way around. Wink.
Ew. Ew. Ew, wink. Ew. Stop winking.
Bum, 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 bum. What's going on, Floobs?
I'm just looking. Does your wife know you abuse women online?
That's what I've been reading, her stupid chats. I never push play on her button. Never on her show. Never, never.
Oh!
Poor Floovies.
Yes.
Dump the dumpster.
Dump the dumpster, Floobs.
Don't go to the dumpster. Is that an apple?
No, it's the sissy pop drop.
Sounds like a fanny, a Granny Mae, Granny Fanny apple.
I guess I should have said it was.
Okay.
Yeah.
Who loves
wait a
you?
Minute, let's...
Doesn't she have to go be a mother?
Who? Debbie, call these people.
I can't add to the call, Dodo Head.
Okay, Dodo's head. You can call them, and I can click on it though. Let's call the tech support people.
That never works.
It will work this because we did it so too soon.
Add them to the call.
Let me see if I can do this. It's oh fuck, it's not even a lot. If for some reason I'm going add people to the call and it's not allowing me to do that.
I think ISIS has hit.
I think so too. Let me see another way. Let me go another way.
We're fixing here Allah Akbar or whatever it is.
Allah Akbar.
Allah Akbar. Are we calling anyone or are you still trying?
I'm trying.
You know what? I'm going to smack you like something silly.
I'm trying. Allah Akbar.
Debbie, we're going into the next phase of production.
Yeah.
Are you really?
Yes.
And?
It looks good. We got a new team member, possibly. And then we have some real big things to work on. We might need some help.
I have to go to the bathroom very quickly.
Well, you know me, Miss Moneybags.
Mm-hmm. Well, not just money. Money's one thing. That's going to work itself out. But we definitely need help in other areas.
That's the reason that JP and Midnight go to Debbie is because she's financing their white guilt project.
That's right.
Her
Maybe
life.
Angela can finance us.
On her welfare check.
Noticed how he pretended not to see that. Sad. At least real men, I know, understand obligations.
Wink.
What?
Did she give you the wink? Notice how he pretended not to see that. Sad. At least the real men and
I
know.
She know about obligations.
You don't know any fucking men. Give me a break. I never push play. I think I pushed play one time this year when she had somebody else as her avatar and I thought it was another show.
Is that what she does?
That's what she said.
These weird attempts at personal attack.
Everything she says is a stupid lie.
Stop creeping me out.
Your head, bathtub girl. Your days are over. Give it up.
Can Annette call in? Why doesn't Annette call in?
Annette, call the fuck in.
Call in. Get drunk. Call in.
Dr. Satan.
Debbie, I'm glad you have directed all this defensive energy at someone else. Ah, he's off the hook. Debbie, you're free and clear. Soar like an eagle.
Debbie sent a sweet tweet out tonight. So I forgive him of everything.
I don't know. I always miss
Debbie. I forgive him of everything he's ever said because it was absolutely sugar plum precious. He said, and I quote, "I never read the dumpster's tweets." Let's see. He said under notifications, don't delete the tweets, Debbie. Disagreeing with Debbie and her ideas and opinions or even making fun of her has nothing to do with how I feel about her as a person. Do you think that was meant good or bad? I retweeted it.
I think he's trying to be good most of the time.
I love Stabby.
Like 60% of the time. He's trying to be good.
Dump the dumpster. Thank you for that cute picture of Vic. That was actually taken a long time ago before he became ruined by the dumpster. He calls me all the time.
You ruin everything you touch.
Yes, I do, sweetie. Oh no, my picture's all up and down the Spreaker board, the Spreaker wall now. Oh, you can see my computer, right? Oh, look at this, the Debbie Daily Show intro. Let's take a listen. With 682 hits, 3 comments. Look at my thing. Here's the original. Now see, I shortened it to this because it was way too long. It now plays, it goes a little bit of something like this. Let me see where it is. I'm laying down. I don't know if I can.
Are your followers fake?
My followers? I have no idea.
That's what's being claimed right here. 1,300 followers are fake.
My followers are fake?
I would not know.
I didn't do it.
Not a very clear message in the board, but I think that's what it's trying to say.
Is it from Dump the Dumpster?
Yeah.
How would I fake followers? How would you do that?
I don't even know how you'd fake 1,300 followers.
Here we go with the way I have it now.
You're listening to the Debbie Daly Show. Now broadcasting live on Spreaker.com. Debbie Daly, changing the world. One caller at a time.
Yes, dear?
So the comment among all comments is rather stupid. The 1,300 followers, okay, and presuming they're fake is nonsense. Spreaker's a social network. So you've probably added everybody that you've...
Yes, I've actually created every one of those accounts and I've added them.
No. Well, what I'm saying is legitimately you add everyone that you meet on Spreaker to build your social network. That's what you do. And that takes time. That's what's called work. That's what's called building your base.
Well, I was always under the impression.
Why would anybody hate on that? Why would anybody hate on that of all things to
because
hate on?
Because I'm jealous of the dumpster.
Followers.
Here's the original file, how long it was. Check this out, JP. This is the original file and how I cut it down.
You're listening to the Debbie Daly Show, the most talked about host from BTR. Now broadcasting live on Spreaker.com. Debbie Daly, changing the world, one caller at a time. Call Debbie now, if you dare.
Call Debbie now, if you dare. Nah, I didn't like it that much. So I cut it down to say just this.
You're listening to the Debbie Daly Show. Now broadcasting live on Spreaker.com. Debbie Daly, changing the world, one caller at a time.
Call Debbie now, if you dare. That stupid bitch has made threats to me about everything in the world. I'm going to have John Wiley.
She has, really?
I'm going to have John Wiley Price. I'm going to have John Wiley Price on my show.
I'm white knighting Debbie tonight, I guess.
Yes, you're a white knight, you putz. You putzoid. Why are you white knighting, Jewish producer?
Reds is going to get his 10th follower, real follower. He's not getting those fake followers like you, Debbie. He's got 9
JP,
followers.
Kissing ass, shit. Nonstop, sad. Where is your
and
show?
Fuck you, Stabby.
Let's all go follow Reds right now. I am. I'm already following Reds. I love his little icon. Isn't he adorable?
Is that a red poopy?
I think it's a red raindrop.
By the way, Reds, I was just your 10th follower. You didn't have to wait till 2016. Congrats.
We love you, Reds. Hey, JP's show is garbage. No need to get personal. Oh, she gets
Stabby.
Real personal.
Stabby's getting a little, he's starting to become a little Angela butt licker himself. Stabby.
1,300 followers? Sure thing, precious. Fake. Gosh, she's fucked up. Girl, you need some fucking help.
I predict that we may have heard her last message of the night because they're just getting dumber and dumber. That's just my prediction.
JP,
prove me wrong.
Does your wife know that you abuse women online? At least the men I know understand obligations. Is that why you don't receive child support from any of your daddy, your baby daddies in the past? Those slack-jawed Mexicans that you screwed? Huh? How about that? We know that you were once under the under the spell of that sexy voice until you saw her on webcam and you went, never mind.
Ew, she's so kooky. Ew, yuck.
Ay, ay, ay.
Ew, stop it, you kooky bitch.
The dumpster look familiar, JP?
Look familiar.
Does that look familiar, JP? Look familiar. Does it look familiar, JP? With that sexy Marilyn Monroe voice that she talks in. Fuck.
Ay, 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 look.
JP.
By the way, I would give her $1,000 if she could tell me where that picture was taken.
She could use it.
$1,000
in buying her new mansion.
Aye, aye, aye.
I'm buying a new house. I just don't know how to do it. It's so hard.
Look how she lashes out. She's going to lash out like this.
She's going to do a show at 4 o'clock in the morning snorting her cocaine and ignoring her minor children.
Ooh, her kookiness is really coming out now.
Aye, aye, aye.
Yeah, ignoring her has not worked. Let's listen to her talk about shopping for a house.
Oh, no. Shantytown.
I'm just going to take a few moments to talk about shopping for a house. I don't want to do this. I do not want to do this.
I do not want to do this. It's like I would rather stay in my government housing over here. Lady, give it up. Get some fucking help, man. See, that's what her friend told me, that she's never gotten psychiatric help, and that's what's wrong with her. And her problems have just festered into madness.
Yeah, I think she's got some something going on. Maybe it's just jealous rage.
I don't know. I do not want to do this. Mr. Midnight Movie, are you sniffing cocaine?
Yeah.
It's dry that, over here.
It's that Oklahoma snot roll. Delicious.
Ouch. Anyway.
It's too frustrating. I can't find what I want. Nothing even close. And
I just can't find what I want. It's nothing even close because, you know, I'm so rich and powerful and I talk like Marilyn Monroe. Fuck.
I have a budget, so... Not my money, mind you. You know, this host is broke. Very broke. Very poor.
It's not my money, mind you. Fuck.
Debbie, are you ever going to forgive Chris Nelson for bailing on you?
Chris Nelson hasn't bailed on me.
Oh.
He just doesn't. He just hates you. Steve called me tonight on a text message and he said, Joseph Mail. He said, and I quote, hi, Debbie.
Whoa, shit, sorry.
What did you just break? I have a minute or so I thought I'd drop you a line. I called your show a couple of weeks ago to apologize for the way that I had behaved. I'm actually just now leaving work. Gotta go. I'm going to be listening tonight. Hopefully we can do a show together soon. And I said, bye.
I'm in Afghanistan right now.
And then we heard Buttercup. Did you hear Buttercup? Listen. Oops.
When's the last time you talked to Chris Nelson?
Hey, Misha, can you come to Katrina with us tomorrow?
Isn't that the voice of an angel?
Buttercup will be played by Chris Nelson. I'm sorry.
No, you I'm run. Sorry. You're the reason we can't have nice things. You run everybody off, you and that damn Jew.
Chris Nelson has. Chris Nelson got mad because you insulted his Lord and Savior.
What? I don't think we're not even going to go there.
You insulted Rick Warren.
Mr. Midnight Movie.
You ran off Chris Nelson.
You ran off Chris Nelson. He's not ran off. He still talks to me all the time.
How are we going to have another man in the relationship if you're going to run? You can't insult Rick Warren. That's his cult leader. He probably gives him like half his paycheck. Now,
the dumpster insults everybody. She's a mean, vile human.
Now, by the way, when's the last time you talked to Mr. Nelson?
Well, sorry. Let me think.
I have allergies, Debbie.
It's dry. The weather's real dry.
I know.
I like it, but it screws with some people's senses.
For the record, I did not tell BTG that this audio massacre was happening. You know what that means? He told her the audio massacre was happening.
Yeah. Whatever Stabby says, the opposite is true.
Yeah, Stabby. No, when he left that night, it was because he was under ambush by my co-hosts here, my temporary co-hosts.
He ran.
He ran like a burnt rabbit. Yeah, da-da-doo, da-doo,
Debbie, I'm sorry, I was on mute. Debbie, he got upset because you insulted Rick Warren.
Mr. Midnight Fluvies.
I think
you're right, but that doesn't mean he's gone. My show was called "If It's Not About Me, I'm Gone." Remember?
Yeah, but okay. What is? Have you talked to him? Have you talked to him recently? By the way,
Joyce tweeted: "Stop trying to work God into your schedule and start working your schedule around God." She tweeted that 3 hours ago. Then she said, "Learn how to think like God wants you to think and build the happy life that He wants for you." Okay, let's see. How much did we make today, Dave? Spend that helping.
Okay. She's got a jet.
Honey, she is. You don't know.
No, this is where it gets wanky right here.
It has made them blind and puffed up. There is a second reason, fear. Fear of Islamic violent terrorist attacks. The very thing that they cannot mention. Here she is. You guys have some crazy ass drama.
For ass or something?
I don't know.
We're talking about $17,000.
When did he hang up?
There you go.
Oh, here he goes. Wait, I'm trying to find it.
Is a Jew on? Is he on live? Because I'm in bed right now.
No. Here's the show when Chris Nelson got mad.
I don't know. I guess I just don't. I mean, I know Rick from listening to all his podcasts, and I'm sure if you Google Rick Warren fraud, you'll find a bunch of little schmuckies who are unknowns online.
Okay,
at
Celebrity Net Worth, which has no. They're not biased at all. It says he's worth $25 million right now. $25 million. That's a lot of money, Chris. That's a lot of money that he's saving for himself and not giving to help.
That is just not true. He's not saving money for himself. How do you know that? What does it matter anyway? Why is it, he's got money when we've
because
got
it's
congressmen
not right.
that steal money right from taxpayers' money.
But we're not talking about them, Chris. We're not talking about them right now. What we're talking about is...
Well, look, this conversation's kind of just going... So, I'm going to bed.
Have you talked to him since, Debbie? Have you met up with him?
And there he goes.
Debbie, have you met up with Chris Nelson?
All you ever want is Chris Nelson drops.
He is. Yes, I do.
So all you want him for is so you can make fun of him.
No,
and I was
Debbie,
being honest with him. I was being honest with him, and he hung up and ran away.
Yeah, but that's what. That's okay.
You can't troll me. You're not a troll. You're I'm a friend of mine. You are. You're trying to be a troll, and you're not a troll. Now stop
it. I'm not trying to troll anybody. I'm
stop. Stop.
His drops are golden. I wish I could do drops like that. And Mr. Solution. I cannot. That man is the drop king. And he's not trying to, but he's amazing. He is simply amazing.
You run off all the good customers.
Yes. You no, Debbie, this was your fault. This
Jewish producer, how dare you sit there and let him do this?
What?
I love it. I secretly love it.
All right, we're going to have a little lie detector test here, Mr. Midnight Movie. Go ahead and say whatever you want to say about Chris Nelson and me.
Yeah, say something nice about Chris or not nice.
I think he is one of the more enjoyable people on Spreaker.
That determines that you're lying.
Why am I lying?
Because you're trying to get me to lure him in here like a spider web.
No, I really... Debbie, you know he's enjoyable. But, Jewish producer, can you find that drop of Chris Nelson, if you can? The one where he's talking to Lester.
Why? Do you think it's funny or what?
Of course I do. That's not a lie. I love that buzzer, by the way.
Buzzer.
At the buzzer, he shoots, he scores.
Where's the buzzer?
Where's the buzzer?
He shoots.
Can you locate that drop, JP?
Who was the guy that you said, strike your magic bow? What's his name?
Froggy Gremlin.
Froggy Gremlin. I used to love that. Froggy Gremlin.
But you can't find the radio show.
I found some of it.
That's a TV show, not the radio. The Buster Brown Hour.
Wasn't it Strike Your Magic, Bo?
It's Pluck Your Magic, Twanger, Froggy.
Here we go.
Pluck Your Magic, Twanger, Froggy!
Did that bring back memories of your childhood?
That was my father's childhood. And actually, it was a radio show before it was a TV show. My father became very disappointed in the TV show.
Okay.
And because he thought, you know, there was more mystery in the in Froggy Gremlin with the Buster Brown.
Funk your magic twanger, Froggy!
I wonder what was going on behind stage at that little bit. Mm-hmm. Here's Amos and Andy. The Kingfish teaches Andy to fly.
Andy, forget about her. There are a lot of other girls will like you just the way you are.
Yeah, but who wants to go out with one of them stupid chicks?
Look, Andy, take my advice and stay away from the gals altogether. Else you're liable to wind up like me, with a wife to greet you with these ever-loving words. Quote.
When are you going to bring home some money?
Unquote.
That was fucking great. And the NAACP had that show taken off the air.
They did?
Oh. Yes.
Okay.
It was terrific, by the way. They should reinstate.
What are we going to do about them?
Well, honey, we'll pay this one.
Pay it with what?
Well, I might get a refund on my income tax.
What income tax? You haven't had an income since there was a tax.
Oh, been that long, huh?
George Stevens, I'm laying down the law right now. I went over and saw the manager of the Eagle Arms Apartments today and got you the job as doorman.
Doorman?
Yes, and you're going to take it.
Why, honey, that's a dangerous job. I might get my hand caught in that there revolving door or hurt my eardrums or blown that whistle for calling the taxi.
It's me, Angela. Did you hear him mention the revolving door?
Yes, I did.
The dumpster has a revolving door of friendship, Midnight.
Well, was that Amos or Andy that went through that?
It doesn't matter. Everybody goes through the revolving door of the dumpster. You will too one day, Midnight. She's evil. Yeah. Very evil human being.
Well, will Chris Nelson come back through it again?
Chris Nelson despises the dumpster. He calls me as many times as Victor does.
Does he really?
Yes, he does. He calls me all the time. He loves my voice.
Yes. I wonder when the last time he called Debbie back.
My sexy Marilyn Monroe voice. I'm the voice in your head, Midnight. Don't go round the dumpster juice. It's just all nasty and stuff.
Debbie's really lost it.
Fuck off, JP. I'm having fun.
That was, by the way, that Amos and Andy was pretty funny.
You're not going to get out of it. We need some money in this house, and it's your job to bring it in.
Honey, ain't I always been an adequate provider?
No.
Well, I was going to answer that question myself. But honey, just give me a couple more days till I get a deal to go in. And
I'm through with your deals.
That's actually an excerpt from the dumpster's house. No, not funny? All right, I'll take the thing off. Y'all are being too hard on me.
Why?
I got you this uniform, and tomorrow morning you go over to the Eagle Arms Apartments and go to work.
You're going to work. I ain't going to go to work, Miss... whatever her name was, whatever.
That was some pretty funny stuff. I forgot how funny Amos and Andy were.
Really? Well, yeah. Maybe now you can remember. And now let's hear from the good times. Good times, anytime you need a payment, good times. Didn't you love the good times, Mr. Midnight movie?
It was pretty funny. That and Sanford and Son. Funny shows. Are we going to play it or not?
It has a disclaimer.
Symbol of Jesus.
Well, hello, Symbol. And goodbye.
JJ hated him.
Don't fangle me, Michael. I had him in the closet where he wasn't performing no miracles for nobody.
Mama, least let Black Jesus hang alongside.
Forget it. The only Jesus I know is him, and the one thing he don't need is a partner. Tosh, out both of you. This picture has been in my family for as long as I can remember. When I was a baby, I don't know what I saw first. My mama, my papa, or this Jesus. Now, he's the one I know and love, so let's close the subject. Jesus was Black, the Bible would have said so.
But it does.
Mm-mm.
I remember that show, by the way.
You do?
Yes, I do.
Hmm.
The painting is of a wine, you know, like it's a Black Jesus, and it turns out he's a wino, the person they painted.
Oh, that's great.
You don't drink no booze?
Nobody good times.
Well, it shouldn't be too hard to find out who's been boozing. I was reading an article that listed the warning signs of an alcoholic. The things to look out for are forgetful, defensive, uncoordinated, and exaggerated sense of one's own importance.
Ah! The holiday season has just begun! And here is your favorite son, Kid of Dynamite!
God, he was so skinny.
He was, man. He was a bony motherfucker.
John Amos can tell us why he quit doing Good Times. Shall we listen to that one?
Yes.
You know, I quit doing Good Times once the NAACP contacted me and said, you know, that's really insulting. Oh, no, that was Amos and Andy, right?
Mm-hmm. The differences we had on that show, and we had a number of differences, as evidenced by my early departure from the show, was I felt that with two other younger children, one of whom aspired to become a Supreme Court justice, that would be Ralph Carter or Michael, and the other, Bernadette Stennis, I think, she aspired to become a surgeon.
They were acting. I'm sorry.
And the differences I had with the producers of the show was that I felt too much emphasis was being put on JJ and his chicken hat and saying dynamite every third page, when just as much emphasis and mileage could have been gotten out of my other two children and the concomitant jokes and you know, humor that could have come out of that. But I wasn't the most diplomatic guy, like I said, in those days, and they got tired of having their lives threatened over jokes, so they said, I'll tell you what, why don't we kill him off and we'll all get on with our lives.
Yeah, you couldn't take a joke, John Amos.
So yeah, but he's probably threatened to kick their asses a couple of times.
Yeah, I'm kind of thinking that was.
I'll kill you, motherfucker. That's what he probably said. Jesus Christ, trying to kill someone over a fucking joke? Are you kidding me? I wonder if Jimmy Walker and John Amos have talked since the show. I mean, really, it was JJ who made the show. Why folks turned in. They didn't.
Wait a minute. Let's take a listen to this. Jimmy Walker explains that Bill Cosby's propensity to be a child molester was widely known. From Jimmy Walker. After we have an ad, which we're going to mute because I'm on Safari, which I don't have my ad blocker. Here we go.
Obama should take away Bill Cosby's Medal of Freedom, our nation's highest civilian award. That is the call from a nonprofit group working to prevent sexual assault, which filed a petition at whitehouse.gov. The White House Press Secretary Josh Earnest said today from the podium that staffers will look to see whether it's legally possible. Bill Cosby, previously known as America's Dad, received the Medal of Freedom in 2002 from then President George W. Bush. Court documents show a decade ago the comedian admitted he got prescriptions of Quaaludes, a powerful sedative, to give to young women whom he targeted for sex. He admitted it. It's seen as a potential smoking gun for the more than two dozen women who have accused him publicly of drugging them and raping them. Meantime, officials at Walt Disney World say they removed a bronze statue of Bill Cosby from the theme park. We reached out for the comedian's reps for a statement. They declined to comment. Jimmy Walker co-starred with Bill Cosby in the 1975 movie Let's Do It Again while he was on the TV show Good Times. And JJ, you were one of my heroes, and it's amazing to see you, and thanks so much for coming.
Oh, thank you for having me. You're one of my faves, too.
Oh, my God. I was watching that other network today, the Red Network, and I didn't know who was interviewing you, but you said everybody in Hollywood knew this, and I'm screaming at the TV, knew what? Everybody in Hollywood knew what?
I think, Shepard, I think everybody knew of Bill Cosby's woman propensity, that he had a lot of different women on a constant level, and it was not really even looked down upon.
Wait, now he's married at the time to the same woman to whom he's married today,
yes,
right?
Yes, Camille America's is a great dad. Woman. They've been married forever and ever. But it was, I think it was normal behavior maybe in those days. If you look at even the women, whether you look at your buddy over on CNN, Anderson Cooper, look at his mom. In her book, she talks about a lot of guys that she's done whatever with. So I think
I want to go back to the story at hand. Jimmy, you knew of how many instances of Bill Cosby and other women?
Well, I knew of at least one. When I was in San Francisco, I was working the Hungry Eye, and a young lady came to the show with a girlfriend who was absolutely gorgeous. I was trying to do what guys do, and I was talking to her, and I said, well, maybe we should do, you know, go out or something. She says, oh, no, I have a boyfriend. He works at the Playboy Club. I said, is this guy a comedian? And at that time, my ego got in the way, Shep, and I said, he can't be bigger than me. And she said, well, my boyfriend is Bill Cosby. And I went, oh, I guess he is bigger than me.
Did you go, oh, I know his wife?
No, I did not say that.
Well,
I did
why, not why say didn't that. You? Come on.
No, because I was more concerned about my own male progress at that time, well, Shep.
But you didn't know, so that I'm clear, did you know about any of this drug business? Did you know about these accusations
the
of Quaaludes?
Shocks, you know, Shep, the joke.
Now, wait but a minute, but I'll step in here and talk about the Bill Cosby's drugs and but women, but he always drugged.
You have a chat message from Stab by McHugs.
Stab by McHugs. He say, Lenny, oh no.
Oh boy.
Why, is he really getting out of his nut? Are there any niggers here tonight? Is he that desperate for shock value? Did he scrape the bottom barrel to be that cruel to say, are there any niggers here tonight? Have I ever talked about the Schwartz and they left the room? Or the Moulin Jeans or the arms who placated some southerner by absence of voice when he rant and raved about the niggers? Are there any niggers here? You know I'm working with a nigger. I think I see one nigger couple back there between those two niggers to three kikes. Thank God for the kikes. And two spicks and one mick. We have two spicks, one mick, three kikes, and one spunky, funky, hunky. Any more boogies? Three more sheenies, eight more guineas, six guineas, seven wops, six grease balls. I pass the six dykes, four kikes, and eight niggers. The point... If President Kennedy got on television every day and said, I would like to introduce all the niggers in my cabinet, and all the niggers called each other niggers, they oftentimes who, but in front of the old phase, and every day you heard nigger, 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 in the second month, nigger would mean as much as good night or God bless you when you sneeze, or perhaps as much as I promise I'll hold to nothing but to do so help me God. Nigger would lose its impact, and it'd never make any four-year-old nigger cry when he came home from school. Zagornish gives it the power, Jim.
I sent that to Stabby to play on the Dumpster Show because I'm going to get her 404 off of Spreaker.com.
You know who that was? The great...
Lenny Bruce.
Lenny Bruce.
And now we'll hear from Richard Pryor.
One thing I got out of it was magic I like to share with you. You know, it's like I was leaving and I was sitting in the hotel and a voice said to me, said, look around. What do you see? And I said, I see all colors of people doing everything, you know? And the voice said, do you see any niggas? And I said, no. And I said, you know why? Because there aren't any. And it hit me like a shot, man. I started crying and shit. I was sitting there, I said, yeah, I've been here 3 weeks. I haven't even said it. I haven't even thought it. And it made me say, oh, my God, I've been wrong. I've been wrong. I got to regroup my shit. I mean, I said, I ain't gonna never call another black man a nigga. You know, because we never was no niggas. That's a word that's used to describe our own wretchedness. And we perpetuate it now because it's dead. That word's dead. We men and women, we come from the first people on the earth. You know, the first people on the earth were black people. Because anthropologists, white anthropologists.
So the white people go, that could be true, you know.
Yeah, Dr. Leakey and them found people remains 5 million years ago in Africa. You know them motherfuckers didn't speak French. So black people, we the first people had thought, right? We the first one to say, where the fuck am I? And how do you get to Detroit? So you can take it for what it's worth. I know, like, I ain't trying to preach nothing to nobody. I'm just talking about my feelings about it. And I don't want them hip white people coming up to me calling me no nigga or telling me nigga jokes. I don't like it. I'm just telling you, it's uncomfortable to me. I don't like it when black people say it to me. I really don't no more. It's nothing. It don't mean nothing. So I love y'all, and you take that with you.
I guess y'all say
Well, I guess nobody was listening that night, were they?
No, they sure weren't.
Nope, they won't listen to somebody as genius as that man. He was excellent.
Now, I was recently watching a documentary on him, and he never buried his demons, and he never... I mean, not until he really got sick did he ever stop abusing drugs. Because everyone thought that after he got those really bad burns and he did Live on the Sunset Strip, that he became clean and sober. And that's what a lot of people thought, but that's not necessarily true. I'm hearing a lot of crickets.
Well, Chris Rock stops. Chris Rock says that word constantly. I think he gives his skin color a bad name. Just saying.
Yeah. Chris Rock is kind of an asshole. The same as Spike Lee. He's kind of a dick face. And I really hate, by the way, Amazing Atheist. He's just an ignoramus who needs a shave. And Stabby, that video of white guilt, him smoking that cigarette with that beard, the man looks hideous and awful. I just thought I'd add that.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, Stabby sent me a thing, The Amazing Atheist, talking about white guilt and talking a lot of emotional rhetoric, which is just, yeah, it was just awful.
Okay. I didn't know, but that's funny. Yeah. I just think
I didn't mean it to be funny.
No, I'm just saying, I just think it's horrible the way blacks talk to each other. Like, listen to this. This is Chris Rock.
Now, we got a lot of things, a lot of racism going on in the world right now. Who's more racist, black people or white people? Black people. You know why? Because we hate black people, too. Everything white people don't like about black people really don't like about black people. There's some shit going on with black people right now. It's like a civil war going on with black people. And there's two sides. It's black people and there's niggas. And niggas have got to go. Every time black people want to have a good time, ignorant ass niggas fuck it up. Can't do shit. Can't do shit without some ignorant ass niggas.
He's talking about TRS. On Blog Talk Radio. Remember how I compared TRS to Mr. Solution one night?
Yes.
Do you remember that really?
I loved it when Mr. Solution would go on TRS. It was one of the most... It was It was almost as entertaining as Amos and Andy. Why am I laughing? It's so
I told everybody one night, I said, here is TRS.
You have a chat message from Wild Goose.
In stars, they say that I'm a boss, that I never miss the mark. I'll stop your beating heart when
I'm... And here is Mr. Solution. I never remember the guy's name, though. I never can remember it. Shit. Never mind. I forgot his name. Goose sends a picture to you from, let's see, he says, here is a picture of, send this to Mr. Solution, he says. I mean, a Mr. Minot movie. Oh, shit. Goose, he just trolled me. Never mind. Don't look at that picture. Asshole. You asshole. And Mr. Solution was described as, I never can remember anybody's name. Oh, wait a minute. I forgot how you spell it. Hold on. Anyway, never mind.
What, is it a really bad picture of me?
No, it's a picture of some naked people.
Message from Wild Goose.
Here's Mr. Solution.
Message from Wild Goose. Message from Wild Goose.
Look at me. I'm as helpless as a kitten up a tree.
He's got class. He's got a lot of class.
You know what would be good during that song is some Chris Nelson and Mr. Solution drops.
See, there you go. You ran Chris Nelson off.
I did not.
You goddamn sure did. You ran him off.
You talked about Rick Warren's millions. He's only worth $25 million after he's been bloviating and telling people to have a purpose-driven life. Oh, I can't believe he's worth that kind of money. Fuck. It's obscene.
Mr. Midnight Movie, would you please read your Skype? Says Wild Goose, since you're laying down and you can't see the chat.
Oh, fuck. Now I got to get out of Betty Bye. All right. There you go. Fuck it. God damn it.
More of Mr. Solution while Mr. Minamu gets out of bed.
Like I'm clinging to
a tree.
Jewish producer, are you still there?
Oh, yeah. I'm listening to this mess.
Oh, fuck me. God damn it.
Mr. Midnight Movie, now you know not to say that on the Dumpster Show.
Oh, shit. Getting up out of fucking bed.
Using me.
Oh, fuck.
Does it hurt that much to move?
It does, man. I'm fucking 250 pounds or maybe 60. I don't know. Oh, shit. Oh. Okay. All right.
Were you sleeping under corn? Never mind.
All right, hold on.
I can't understand. I get misty. Just holding your hand.
Mr. Midnight Movie, Mr. Solution is pure class, and you run off all the help around here.
Yeah, where's the chat that you sent? Where's the chat? I don't see it. Is it just Wild Goose chatting me?
I think he sent you a picture.
Let me see here. A Wild Goose sent me a picture. Okay.
I cannot believe what I'm looking at right here.
The goose picture he sent, no. Isn't that nasty?
Oh my God, you gotta be kidding me.
Yeah, it's pretty nasty.
Take a look.
You're gonna love this. You're gonna love it.
Oh fuck, is that really the Amazing Atheist? Is that poo out of his anus?
Is that really him?
Stabby. Oh yes. My God, is he fucking shitting on himself? Yeah. What the fuck is... What?
Smear it all around.
Wait a minute. He's pouring syrup and then he's cuck... And then he's... Is that caca?
Now, wait a minute, guys. Now, wait just a second.
Wait. What the fuck? What is he doing? That's a pickle. Is that anus? Oh, God. That is real caca. Oh, my God. It's caca. Oh, God. You know, fuck you.
Amazing caca.
You know, fuck you. You know, atheist, amazing atheist, eat shit. You are so, you know, after that. Oh my God.
You're not telling him to do anything he wouldn't already do.
Here's what Goose posted in the Dumpsters chat room, everybody, if you'd like to take a look.
Goose, how does Goose come up with this stuff?
That is, you know, Wild Goose, that is amazing. And it just, oh my God.
But Goose has never swatted his bark, because I would know. I would hear the rumblings in the chat rooms.
Is that a cucumber? What was that?
I'm not looking at it. I refuse to look at it. Don't look at it.
He said it's a banana. Let me look here. What did he send me?
Do you mean people actually do that stuff? Are you kidding me?
But no, wait. Is that fudge or is that real caca? And why would he do that? Why would he put a pickle up? Is that a pickle up his butt?
Mr. Man, that movie, he's trolling you. That's not him.
Oh, fuck it. I had to look close because I hate that guy. Now, I'm going to show those pictures to Amazing Atheist.
Don't tell him where it's from.
That looks just like him.
20, 40, 60, 80, 100.
Peekaboo.
20. Peekaboo. I got cockapoo.
We have an emergency alert. Hold on.
Picture 201.
Flash flood warning this area until 4:15 a.m. Avoid flooding areas. See your local... Sorry, my phone just went off. I have emergency alerts on it.
Goose is saying that it's really him, that that's not some kind of cockamamie bullshit.
Should we let him believe it, Mr. Minamimi? I mean, a Jewish producer?
Banana Gate.
JP, shut up.
Banana Gate.
Oh my God.
I'm as helpless as a kitten up a tree. Meow.
Message from Wild Goose.
What?
There's a video. Mr. Midnight Movie, there's a video.
Coming right up. Oh boy, I'm not going to look. Y'all can look.
Oh boy. Oh, good Lord. It's him.
This is Rand Paul. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Oh.
Is he going to caca? Let's see if he's going to caca.
Look at his little winky. What is
that? That's him, dude. That's not a fake. Oh, no, Jesus.
That's really him? Ow. Are you serious? It says Amazing Atheist, Rand Paul.
This is a lot hotter than the oil I poured on my ass. So
he's pouring hot oil on his dick!
He doesn't have a dick. Look at that little thing.
Is he gonna caca? Why is he doing this?
Makes him better at his show.
I burnt my winky winky.
This is not fake. He really did this. This is. Oh my God! You're such a sick fuck.
No! No!
Is he gonna cucky? Why is he doing this? He's putting hot water in his dick.
Still have, oh boy.
Some oil left.
Oh God.
I'm sticking my balls in it.
No. No.
Is that really him?
No.
Oh, please don't.
Oh my God.
You know, the internet is such a sick fuck place. Look at these. There's these. These people actually vote. This is some sick stuff. These people actually vote. They have driver's license. They breed.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Oh, hell no.
Oh, fuck.
No way.
Ooh, look what he's doing.
Oh, God, no.
Why? Oh, why?
Oh, Jesus Christ.
No, thank you. I'm tired. I'm done with that shit. That's grotesque. I cannot believe these people are actually alive.
And this guy gets thousands of hits. He's done something that fucking nasty.
There's a lot of fucked up people in the world. A lot of fucked up people.
Ew.
Can you fathom that? Can you imagine? Ugh. Sorry, I can't handle that.
Oh, God. Ugh.
Uh-oh, listen to the thunder. And the thunder rolls.
Oh, my fucking God.
3:30 in the morning. Not a soul inside. I'm all by myself. And the thunder rolls, and the thunder rolls.
You know, you know what? I thought I had no respect for the amazing atheist. Now I have no, like, I mean, he's lost all credibility to put fucking, what kind of hot juice or hot shit was that on his dick and then on his anus? It's unbelievable.
Greetings, citizens of the motherfucking YouTube. I am your beloved Amazing Atheist, and it's been a while since I've done a Q&A here on the Amazing Atheist.
Oh, I can't listen to stuff. I'm afraid I'm going to go to hell. Oh, here's one. White guilt? Shut up.
Oh, I've heard that, yeah.
I'm the Amazing Atheist. I'm smoking a cigarette because, fuck longevity. You know how that shit goes. Who wants to be hanging around this planet longer than you're needed? You know, eventually you just become a doddering old fool. Hey, don't like the music these kids are listening to. Actually, I already don't like the music these kids are listening to. It's fucking shit. So maybe it's already time for my fat ass to go. Hopefully that heart attack is right around the corner. Anyway, the feminists of the internet rejoice. Yeah, he's dead! Woo! He's finally dead! Anyway, I'm here to talk about white guilt, because my last video was about race, and the last Drunken Peasants podcast also delved into the topic of race. Been getting in scraps with the I'm not racist of the world, the people who are racist in everything they say, and they'll say shit like, black people just need to stop committing crimes, but they're not racist. No. Because, of course, they have statistics. Look, black people do commit more crimes. It's like, okay, what about these other statistics over here?
Message from Wild Goose.
Way poorer than white people on average. What about these statistics over here that show that they are persecuted by the police more and that the court system is not fair to them? What about those statistics? And a million others.
Behold the atheist's nightmare.
So for those of you who haven't heard, I've recently become embroiled in a sex scandal involving chocolate syrup, hot coffee, and a banana, which apparently is the atheist's worst nightmare. Ray Comfort, you truly are a prophet. So a highly personal video of mine leaked onto the internet, and I have no right to complain. I jerked off to the Scarlett Johansson photos that leaked just like everyone else did. So I really have no right to get on camera and cry about this. Further, the things depicted in the video and photo that leaked are things that I did and enjoyed at the request of a girl that I knew and was talking to at the time. In fact, a girl that I still talk to. I sent it to a few other girls that I talked to on the side, and apparently one of them decided to share it with the world. I don't know who it was, nor do I really care. The things that I did because I enjoy them. I wasn't ashamed of them when I was doing them in private. I see no reason to be ashamed of them now that they've been made public. You know, and when the leak happened and I saw that it wasn't going to be contained, that it was going to spread like wildfire, I figure, well, who cares? My fans are pretty cool. They'll know what's up. They're not gonna judge me for this shit. Next thing I know, my inbox is flooded. Some people are like, I used to respect you, man, but now I don't anymore because I just can't believe what I've seen. I can't believe what you did in the privacy of your own bedroom. Yeah. And then there's people like, is it real? It's not real, right? It's like someone photoshopped that, right? It's not real, right? It's not you, huh? And then there's the trolls from 4chan like, you mad, brah? You mad, brah? Yeah, we got you, bitch. We got you now. You're fucking done for, bro. I'm sad to report that it was a minority of people who sent me messages like, yeah, I saw it, but I don't really care. It doesn't really change my opinion. It doesn't really matter to me. That's something you were doing in private. It was never meant to be on the internet. But, you know, this shit happens and it's not a big deal. But then again, the reason a lot of people might not have sent that is because it's kind of fucking obvious. I mean, what reputation exactly is this supposed to tarnish? My reputation as a wholesome family man who espouses Christian values?
You know what I hate? I hate cops.
My reputation as a respected pillar of the academic community?
We are in love, no? We love each other. We kiss each other. We make the love to each other.
I mean, let's face it here. I am and always have been a fucking weirdo. 90% of you, if you really thought about it, would have been able to figure out that I was doing some weird shit like this in my spare time in the first place.
I say this, peace the fuck out.
I think that's a great rebuttal. No pun intended.
Are you going against me? This guy's a schmuck off.
I just think that if something like that were to come out for one of your videos, I think that you would have no other option than to come out and talk the way it is, just like he did.
Yeah. Wild Goose says, fuck his points, I want to talk about his dick.
And there's that.
From what I can see, he has no dick.
The guy is, yeah. I mean, was there caca? Did he smear caca? Like, did he shit and
look at
caca?
His little bitty tiny. Look at his little bitty tiny dick. Look how little it is. You can barely see it. That's him. That's really him.
Oh God, well, Jesus Christ! I don't want to hear his fucking heavy breathing.
That's just gross.
Yeah, I mean,
hope you enjoy listening to him now, Mr. Midnight Movie.
Did he put an enema up himself? And
yes,
then
he's gross. Make me vomit. And look at the color of the bread spread. It was the same color in this one over here on this one. The same, the one we saw before that. Not this one, but other one.
I don't think he changed it.
What a sick fuck.
Greetings, citizens.
Ugh, make me puke. That's just gross. I'm sorry. This gross. That's sick shit. That is gross. Sorry. Well,
I'm going to go to Betty. Bye. By the way, Justin Bateman looks really scrawny.
Justin Bateman looked what?
Justin Bateman.
Looked what?
She looked really. She's gotten really scrawny looking.
Yeah, she lost a ton of weight.
Do you think it's meth?
I don't know. No. And I don't really care. Who is she, Justine Bateman?
Remember Family Ties?
Yes.
Jason Bateman's sister.
Lab mix, humans and dog. Oh my God. There's some stupid stuff on the internet. You know, some really stupid fucking shit on the internet. People that do certain things. This chick right here was awesome. The one that shot the bow and arrow with her legs. She was pretty amazing. I don't know where she is, though. That's what Steven dreams of doing. Cool. We are so boring tonight.
I wonder how much The Amazing Atheist is worth.
Look it up.
Right.
It should tell you on Google how much he's worth.
That guy's worth anything, I'm going to be.
I'm sure he's making money on YouTube. Excuse me. I'm sure he's making money on YouTube. Just saying.
That would anger me. Let's see what his net worth is.
Who gives a shit? What a freak. I can't imagine doing that shit. I mean, can you imagine? Fuck that. That's horrible. I'm sorry. That's gross. I don't have any time for people like that. I mean, that's just, that's sick.
I think him and Chris Nelson should have a debate.
There you go. You hear that thunder? That's Chris Nelson's thunder. Oh, I'm so bored. I am. I'm so bored.
God, that.
Well, how much is he worth?
It didn't. I can't find his net worth.
You should type in. I bet I could find it.
You find. You tell me.
People who, because I'm laying down. People who make money on YouTube, he'll have it. Just saying.
What's his name again? What's his name anyway? What's his real name?
You would just put in the amazing atheist.
I put in amazing atheist network, and it did not have.
You had to put in YouTube, probably. I don't have any of my bath salts. I'm so pissed off. I ran out yesterday. Damn it. I love these bath salts that I use. It's
Mr. Midnight Movie. His name is T.J. Kirk.
T.J. Kirk. Anyway, I'm so pissed off. I love taking a bath in lavender bath salts that I have, and I'm out of the damn things, and I don't feel like going to the store to get any. Just saying, anyway. Boring day.
I want to know how much he's. As an example of his respected and care for fellow human. In his video, Rape Feminism. Okay. Tits versus ass. Pedophilia. Kirk made a post on Marilyn Manson forum in his pre-YouTube days in which he advocated lowering the age of consent to 12 or 13 and admitted to having sex, having had extreme pedophilic fantasies, in fact, admitted to having dated a 14-year-old girl when he was 23. Jesus Christ. Bullying, on a controversial video, Bullies, where he expressed the view that being a bully doesn't make you a monster and being bullied doesn't make you a victim, and called suicidal bully victims weak. This led to very mixed reaction amongst his audience. He responded to intense criticism with a follow video, macho trolling. This caring, empathetic attitude was again revealed in his treatment of the story of Amanda Todd, a teenage girl who committed suicide in October 2012, not long after posting.
You have a chat message for Monette.
Chat message for Monette.
Yeah, but I don't have them tonight, Netter Pops. Damn it. Live and let die, boom, boom, live and let die. That's Heather's new live song. She's turned into a bitch.
E-begging and accusations of scams. Kirk is an e-begger. And
make it stop, Jewish producer.
I'm going to bed.
Fuck it, man. I was interested.
Good night. Thank you, Debbie.
Message from Annette.
When are you going to read me a bedtime story? You were reading me at one time Larry Elder's book.
I'll read you a bedtime story. You really want a bedtime story?
Actually, I want to take a shower and hit the heady hay.
All right, no bedtime story? Not even a quickie?
What are you going to read from me?
I don't know. It's whatever you want me to read. I can read a little story called The Joyride. No, I want to read an old one. A good one of the Aesop's fables, maybe.
Message from Annette.
Yeah, da da dee dee dee. Aesop's fables.
I thought it was Aesop.
Whatever. I say Aesop. You say Aesop. Doesn't matter. Now, look at all these choices we have. The ass in the lion's skin. The Bald Man and the Fly Fable.
Why don't you find me his...
Message from Stab by Chugs.
Shut up, Stabby. Stabby, here's how you need to spell your name to get it to sound right. Let me show you what to say, okay, Pumpkin? Put this. Put Stab E...
Message from Annette.
That's the only way the reader can read it. Let me check it. Hold on. Let me highlight that and hit read it, reader.
Stab beam chugs.
Why is it saying but chugs? All right, let's try it another way. Hold on. Stab E Mac hugs. Let's try it like this. Hold on. Enter. We have to get it to read that right because that's really giving you, not giving you away. Ah, shit. Hold on. Be still.
Stab E Mac hugs.
Stab E Mac hugs. Write it like I wrote it right there, Angel. Stab E Mac hugs. M chugs. Yeah, it says it just perfect like this.
Stab E Mac hugs.
Stab E Mac hugs. So, what have we learned tonight?
Message from Annette.
We learned that one angry. Amazing atheist is a real scumbag.
Absolutely. I would never do anything like that. I would never do anything like that anyway.
He dated a 14-year-old when he was 23.
Let's take him down.
Yeah, no, he's a scumbag.
Have we got him doxxed? That's just gross.
Yeah.
I'm going to read the hair and the
message
tortoise.
From Annette.
Debbie, I got to get my sorry about the bed. I'm so sorry.
Go to bed. Good night.
Good night, Debbie. Good night, JP.
Love you so much. Love you so much. Asshole.
So much it hurts.
Yes, it does. Just like the angry atheist or whatever his fucking name is.
Amazing atheist.
Whatever.
Get it right. We'll have a debate between him and Chris.
Message from Stab by MC Hugs.
No, you didn't fix it.
Stab by MC Hugs.
He didn't fix it. Good night, Jewish producer. And don't go around the dumpster. Well, now it's just me. I've taken over Debbie's show. And as you know, my name is Angela, and I have a very sexy voice. And I've been known to tell lies about the dumpster. Let's just get right down to it here, shall we? Now, Mr. Solution, what do you mean, good night, Mr. Solution? Now, the dumpster once called my minor children, and she tried to take them across state lines, and Victor calls me all the time, and fuck it, I'm tired of talking like her. Just go and listen to her freaking bullshit if you want to listen to her talk. She's a nutcase. If you want to get a good... You know something? I'm going to tell you, Jimmy Walker doesn't look that good. I'm going to screenshot this and put it on the I'm page to show y'all how bad he doesn't look too good. I don't think life has been too good to the Jimster. Not looking too good, Jimmo. Here he is. If you want to take a look at Jimmy Walker, he is not looking too good. Not looking too good. Oh, screw it. I'm not going to do all that cutting and pasting. I'm just going to send it like this. That's going to show all the dumpster stuff on our computer now, isn't it? Isn't that going to show all our stuff on our computer? But I have nothing to hide. I love all of you just as much as I do the next person. Who wants to hear Bo Peep talk again? I just love this. Mr. Midnight did it. Wait a minute. I didn't hear you. It came across my iPhone.
I'm going to say something. Hey, Mika, can you come trick-or-treating with us tomorrow?
Yes, love, love, baby, love, angel, love, love, love. Precious little thing, the most precious baby in the whole world I've ever loved before in my entire lifetime. Absolutely the reason I breathe. Mika, can you come trick-or-treating with us tomorrow? Oh, he just melts my heart. All right, here comes the picture of Jimmy Walker. He's not looking too good, boys. Not looking too good. He's not so dynamite as he used to be. Where's my chat room at? Where's my chat room? There it is. Check this out. He doesn't look too good. The old Jimmy Walker, Kid Dynamite. What is this? Shutterstock. What is that? Why is there a picture of a gold? It looks like a gold smoker or something. What is that? Oh, a golden dumpster. I think Jabby loves Angela. I think it's his sweet love. That's his love. Did y'all look at how bad Kid Dynamite looks? He's not looking too good there, is he? Not looking too good. He looks a little tired. Oh, I don't know. Why do I keep clicking these links? Why do you keep showing me gold trash cans full of money? What is that? Stab E. Maghugs. Oh, Annette, I need you. I feel like shit today. I'm kind of tired, to be honest with you. He does? He does crack cocaine. He doesn't look too good, to be honest with you. I can't stand this picture anymore. I got to change my picture back. I got to change my picture back. That's me, Angela, back when the dumpster photoshopped that. She photoshopped that picture of me. She photoshops everything of me. Yeah, right. I know what made me not feel good. I had a chicken pot pie earlier. Why is it chicken pot pies always make you feel like shit? What is it about them? And they always burn your tongue because they never cool down. Have you ever noticed that? When you're real hungry and you make a chicken pot pie, it takes forever for it to cool down. I'm going to make a report on the dumpster. I'm going to make a report to Spreaker.com. I wonder why Juice Talk Radio has got my Debbie Daly Show intro showing on the main board.
You're listening to the Debbie Daly Show, the most talked about host from BTR. Now broadcasting live on Spreaker.com. Debbie Daly, changing the world, one caller at a time. Call Debbie now, if you dare.
Let's just see what...
You're on air with Dallas White.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Let's just see who's leading the pack in Spreaker Jingles here for number one hits. I bet I know who. I bet I know who. There's 11 episodes. And guess who's number one? The Debbie Daly Show intro. I thought she had the most amazing voice when I got that. Of course, now we all know the dumpster followed us all over here from Blog Talk Radio because we just had to get away from her. She better be glad she deleted that last show, you jerk. Well, it's officially Halloween. Happy Halloween, everybody. I hope everybody has a fun time tonight. It'll be raining cats and dogs, and don't step in a poodle. So I guess to close out, we will listen to the most popular Halloween song that we always play, which is, of course, as we all know, what song is to always play? I think I have to stop smoking weed. Makes me forget everything. Oh, I know. I can't think of the name of it. Damn. I really am going crazy, I think. I'll have to talk about something else until I think about it. All right, let's read this. Dear Victor, as a valued State Farm customer, I got it already. I already got it. No, I didn't. I forgot it. Shit. I got it. Here we go with the most popular Halloween song in the whole world.
I was peeking up here.
Okay, shut up. We don't want to hear you talking and have a live version and all that bullshit. Just play the damn thing, okay? Another live version. Are you kidding me? Does anybody not upload anything that is not live anymore? Anybody in the world? I was working in the lab.
My eyes beheld an eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the castle east, to the master bedroom at the vampire's feast. The ghouls all came from their humble abode to get a jolt from my electrode.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash. The zombies were having fun. The party had just begun. The guest included Wolfman, Dracula, and his son. The scene was rocking, all were digging the sounds. Igor on chains, backed by his baying hounds. The coffin bangers were about to arrive with their vocal group, the Crypt Kicker Five.
They played the mash.
They played the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They played the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They played the mash.
They played the monster mash. Out from his coffin, Rex's voice did ring. Seemed he was troubled by just one thing. Opened the lid and shook his fist and said,
you have reached the voicemail box of 214.
Haha, you thought you were going to hear that. We're going to try to call one more time. He changed it to Stab E. Mac Hugs.
Hello.
Hello, Victor. It's me, Angela. How are you?
Angela who?
Angela, your girlfriend that you call all the time.
Oh, the Herfer from Oklahoma?
Yes, I said tonight in the dumpster's chat room, I said, now Victor calls me all the time, wink, wink. So we can't let anybody, we can't let anybody know that you're talking to me, but I how hard is it to be married to the dumpster? And do you take her to the insane asylum often?
No, but, you know, I've got your phone number from the toilet. Off the toilet stall at the truck stop on I-30.
I love you, Victor. Why don't you leave the dumpster?
And come north to the, what, the armpit of the United States?
You're not making any sense, Victor.
There, no, that's the angel I know.
Yes, I cackle like a witch. I'm going to put a spell on the dumpster, Victor.
Yeah.
You know what she said? And like, hold on, take this effect off. You know what she said in the chat room tonight? She said, wherever it is, she might have deleted it already. Oh, here it is. It's called Dump the Dumpster. She said, JP kissing ass nonstop is so sad. Where is your show? And then she said, Mr. Midnight Movie is still living with his father and he's almost 50. Notice how he pretends not to see that. At least the real men I know understand obligations. Then she said, wink, wink, guess who has called me to flirt with me, dumpster? A man in need of love. Are you in need of love, Victor? She's yeah. Fucking nuts.
Kind of like those guys with those donkeys. Where is that? Out in Brazil or some crap? They don't want to marry a donkey.
Why don't you just be honest and tell us what you really think of Angela Truth, Victor?
Hey. She's the best-looking donkey this side of Pecos.
All right. Well, thank you for talking to us tonight, Victor. Wink, wink.
Let's hear you give your witch cackle again.
I don't know how to do that.
You have to be a real witch.
Yep. All right. Goodbye. Thank you for talking to us, Victor. The Victor loves me. Oh, she's an idiot. So there you go. You heard it straight. Hold on. From Victor. Back to the Monster Mash.
Whatever happened to my Transylvania twist?
It's now the Mash.
It's now the Monster Mash.
The Monster Mash.
And it's a graveyard smash.
It's now the Mash.
It's hot on and it's live.
It's now the Mash.
It's now the Monster Mash. Now everything's cool. Drax a part of the band in my Monster Mash. The hit of the land. For you, the living, this mash was meant to. When you get to my door, tell them Gordy sent
you. Then you can mash.
Then you can monster mash.
The monster mash.
And do my graveyard smash.
Then you can mash.
You'll catch on in a flash.
Then you can mash.
Then you can monster mash.